Oksana Nechyporenko is the director of an NGO in Ukraine. She was also the chief of staff for the former prime minister, and she joins us now from Warsaw. Oksana, we've just seen in our story there many Ukrainians are defiant. There's clearly also going to be fear as well. Which of those two things do you think is stronger right now?
I can't say that something is stronger. I can say that it's a crazy mixture of both, and it depends on the time. When you read the news, sometimes you feel very scared because you literally don't know what to do, because you never thought that you'll find yourself in the situation in the 21st century, in a European country, in the middle of Europe, being afraid of the war, of actual missiles going into your capital city and destroying everything. I mean, it's crazy even to think about it. But on the other hand, you feel anger. You are so angry on this crazy neighbor of ours who has this power to tell us whether we can be free or not be free, whether can we be democratic or we can't. I mean, it's, and this emotional roller coaster is really something that warns us down, I must tell you very frankly.
Things have definitely escalated. How are people preparing?
Oh, so there are different ways too. Some are evacuating themselves or their families to Western Ukraine or to other countries, somebody is staying. The one who are staying, we are advised to A, be always prepared to evacuate. We have our cars with the full tanks all the time, have our documents with us, a little bit of cash, and the emergency bag prepared, have extra food, extra water, and understand where should we go to or where should we run to. Lots of people are going to special first aid courses. I am one of them. I just took first aid courses. Now I know, and now I can be a little bit more useful to my people if something happens. Somebody are signing themselves for territorial defense for the weekends to understand actually how to fight back. So each of us are trying to do something. But the majority of us, we are staying. We are staying because we need, I mean, it's our country. We have nowhere to run to.
Oksana, you say people, some people are evacuating, but you're in Warsaw right now, but you're about to jump on a plane to go back to your home in Ukraine. Some people will be going, why are you going back to a potential war zone?
Look, I took a lot of thought about that. So I evacuated my family, my mom, my parents to Western Ukraine, but I and my sisters and our families decided to stay in Kyiv and to protect Kyiv because we think that we have to protect. We have to do that. We don't have other choice. We don't have nobody else to do that for us. It's our fight and we are ready to take it.
Oksana, this conflict has been going on for years now. Is there a sense in the Ukraine that you just want it over with? And if so, how does that happen? And what's your message to the West as we head towards this precipice?
Look, we are living in this war already for 7 years in this state, but this time it's much worse because we never thought that all our country can be under the threat of invasion. Or again, any talks about missiles flying over our heads can be a serious discussion in this time of the development of the civilization. We feel the huge support of international community. We do feel it. We feel that you are more united than you used to be 7 years ago when our neighbor had an aggression towards us and started a war and annexed our territories. But we also understand that you won't be fighting for us. It's our fight, but we'll be more than happy and appreciate if you can help us because Russia is a huge aggressor and we can't compete with them in our military forces. We need some defense. We believe that if we are destined to stop Putin, this modern Hitler, then probably that's our destiny and we'll do that. So we appreciate if you talk about that. If you would understand what situation we are in, because again, we are just ordinary people who just want to live our lives and somehow we are told that we can't do that. And this is the situation that I would never wish that any of you would ever be, because it totally, it ruins your life and your plans and everything. So thank you so much for the support and for unity that you have. But we need more. We need for you to be more vocal. We need for you to think of what else can be done, even if you are so far away from us. And we need you just to remember that we are there and we are fighting wars in the 21st century, unfortunately.
Oksana, thank you so much for speaking to us tonight. I was going to say have a safe flight, but there's something sort of oddly chilling about even saying that in the current circumstances. Either way, we appreciate your time. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.